2018ko Bosnia eta Kroaziaren arteko muga igaro bide nagusi bilakatu da Balkanetako bidea jarraituz Europako batasunera iristeko alegina egiten duten milaka migratzaileentzat. Bosniako iparmendebaldeko Unasana kantoian une honetan 3000 pertsona migratzaile baino gehiago daude, kanpalekuetan, basoetan eta eraikin abandonatuetan bizitzen. Hemendik Kroaziako muga gurutzatu eta oinez Italiaraino iristeko alegina egiten dute, baina kasu gehienetan poliziak harrapatu eta modu ilegalean itzuli egiten ditu.
On this border between Croatia and Bosnia, every day people on the move are pushed back from Croatian authorities with violence against single men, but also against women and unaccompanied minors and also against kids.
Last Friday we go to a game. We go to a game, there's a lot of police, they take us, they take our bags, clothes, shoes, and they report back again to Bosnia. And also they take our phone, power bank, money. When they check us, our bags, they say, give me some gift to me. Today's my birthday. Also they take us for phone, give me phone. We say we don't have. Then they report to Bosnia.
Bihatxiriaren kanpoaldean, serbiarrek Bosniako gerran zehar bombardaturiko fabrika honetan, orain Afganistango eta Pakistango onda 50 gazte inguru bizi dira. Duinak izatetik urrun dauden bizi baldintzekin.
دلته کې مونږ ته پرابلم دا پرابلم دی چې مونږ د واتمې شې د تیرې کې نور نفرم دی دلته دنیا خلک پراته دي یو خو مونږ ته د اوبو مسله ډېره ده نه اوبه شته دی نه داسې د خوراک سیستم شته دی نه د شپې دلته کې مونږ په دې ځینو کې پراته یو سپږې په مونږ کې وشوې قسم قسم حالاتونو سره مونږ مخ شو خارښتونه راباندې ولګېده او ډېر په تکلیف او ډېر په یو دغه کې راځي او
People on the move that reach Croatia and they tell to the police that they want to ask asylum in Croatia. Police used to say that they doesn't care, they cannot ask asylum in Croatia. Croatia is not a country for them, and they leave them to the border between Croatia and Bosnia. But it's not just Croatia, it's also Slovenia, and from May 2020 it's also Italy. Italian police used to give them to Croatian authorities, Slovenian authorities, and then to Croatian authorities. So at the end they arrive again to Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Bosanska boina herrian, Kroaziako mugatik oso gertu, Bosniako gerraz geroztik utxik geratu diren etxe bizitza ugari daude. Eta horietan orain Afganistango, Pakistango eta Bangladesko familiak bizi dira. Elektrizitaterik eta urkorronterik gabe.
Here. 29 person. Just here. No good, but too much cold night. Here don't have water, don't have shower. Police corps was very, very angry, but beat and taking my clothes in the fire, put in the fire, taking my phone, taking my money, taking my clothes, but beat my father.
Actually, I tried it more than 30 times, more than 30 times. Every time they are catch me and they are taking my phone, my money, my anything, all also same. They are beat me again, and they are push me back in here. But one time I asked them, why should you do with us look like this? We are also humans, not animals. They are told me it's all about from Germany. If they are told us to must be catch you, we must be catch you. If they are told us to release them, we will release you, but now that they are told us we must catch you and beat you sometime.
It's not just Croatian, it's since also Croatia is an European country, it's mainly also European Union that is using this parallel system to say, okay, let's to financiate Bosnia and Herzegovina for the management of migration crisis. So let's keep the people, the transit community, the people on the move in this country that is not an European country. And we create this, they create this parallel system where, the first perpetrators are Croatian authorities in this case, but behind this there is the rule of the European Union.